Good afternoon. Can I remind members of the COVID-related measures that are in place and that face coverings should be worn when moving around the chamber and across the Holyrood campus? The first item of business this afternoon is time for reflection, and our time for reflection leader today is Reverend Dr. James Connolly, Minister of Dundee West Parish Church of Scotland.
Presiding Officer, members of the Scottish Parliament, thank you for the opportunity to address you this afternoon. Let us consider how to stir up one another to love and good works, says the writer to the Hebrews, chapter 10 and verse 24. While a patrol leader in the Boy Scouts, I had the nickname Spoon. It was given me because of the folding spoon I used to check the food the boys cooked when at camp. I took this very seriously, shoveling a good measure, just to make sure it was safe to eat. Most of the time it was. That spoon was helpful and ever ready. Some resented it, thinking of it as interference. Others were thankful, and most accepted it as something to be done. Later, when I came to Fife, I was informed that you need a lang spoon to sup with a fifer. I had long ago put that folding spoon away. Now it seemed I needed a lang spoon, ASAP. What did it mean? I learned it meant five people could be challenging to get to know. As a clergyman, working for 16 years in Fife, I found that they, like us, are all Jock Thompson's bairns. The lang spoon required humility, sacrifice, and sometimes suffering, but mainly Christian love, reaching out with unconditional positive regard to all. I was introduced to another Fife spoon, a spoon, a wooden double-backed spoon. It multiplies mixing and beating using the same effort. Neil Robertson credited it along with good Scottish water in helping him win the World Porridge Making Championship. The appliance of science, but also good Scottish ingenuity. Finally, there's the metal pudding spoon. Noah, my six-year-old grandson, believes it's magic. You see, one side shows your reflection the right way up, whilst the other displays it upside down. When things seem upside down, we need to learn to turn for the right way up. The writer to the Hebrews, when using the word stir, is thinking in terms of agitation, even irritation. And in truth, when looked at the right way round, this does spur us on to something good. I trust that we will continue to learn how best to stir one another up to love and good works, and are ever ready to check and keep all safe so they may advance with care, knowing that Jock Thompson's bairns are precious and to be cared for throughout life.
Thank you. Thank you, Reverend Dr. Connolly.